Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a free, complete course for the CCNA 200-301. If you like these videos, please subscribe to follow along with the series. Also, please like and leave a comment, and share the video to help spread this free series of videos. Thanks for your help. In this lab, we'll configure interfaces on a router and two switches. This is a single LAN, 172.16.0.0/16, connected to R1's G00 interface. In the real world, R1 would then connect to other LANs or perhaps the internet, but we'll just configure this small LAN for now. Let's get started. So there are six main steps in this lab. 1. Configure host names. 2. Configure IP addresses. 3. Configure speed and duplex. 4. Configure interface descriptions. 5. Disable unused interfaces. And 6. Save the configurations. Instead of going through each step one by one, I'll go through the steps one device at a time, but you can do it in any order you like. So let's go on R1 first. The first step is to configure the host name. As you can see, it currently has the default hostname of router, as indicated by the prompt here. Let's change it to R1. Use enable to enter privileged exec mode, then configure terminal to enter global config mode. From here, simply type hostname R1, and you can see the prompt has changed to indicate the new hostname. Now let's configure the IP address on its G00 interface. Type interface G00 to enter interface config mode for the interface. Actually, before doing the configuration, let's confirm the current status of the interface. Do show IP interface brief. Remember, do lets me use the show command, even though I'm not in privileged exec mode. Here's the gigabit Ethernet 00 interface. The IP address is unassigned, so the method is unset, and the status is administratively down, because that's the default setting for router interfaces. Let's configure it, and then check again after. So, let's configure the IP address. IP address, 172.16.255.254, and because the prefix length is /16, the subnet mask will be 255.255.0.0. Okay, now because this interface is connected to another networking device, switch 1, I'll manually configure the speed and duplex. Speed 1000, meaning 1000 megabits per second, because this is a gigabit Ethernet interface. Then, duplex full. Devices attached to switches can use full duplex. There's no reason to use half duplex like a device attached to a hub. Next, let's configure a description. I'll indicate that this device is connected to switch 1, so description to switch 1. Now, the last step is to disable interfaces which are not connected to other devices. Because router interfaces are shut down by default, we don't have to do that. However, we do have to do the opposite for this interface, which is connected to another device. So, no shutdown. There we go. Now the interface is enabled, and let's check out the status. Do show IP interface brief. Okay, you can see the IP address we configured. The method is manual. The status is up, but the protocol is down. Although on a real Cisco device, I think this should be up, up. On Packet Tracer, it's down because I manually configured the speed and duplex on this interface without doing so on Switch 1's interface, but we'll fix that soon. That's a downside of using a simulator like Packet Tracer. Sometimes things don't behave like they should on a real device. Before moving on to Switch 1, I'll configure descriptions on R1's other interfaces to indicate that they are not in use. I'll use the interface range command. Interface range G01 to 2. Description, not in use. Okay, let's check our config. Do show run. Here's the running config of the device, and here are the configurations of the interface, including speed, duplex, IP addresses, and descriptions. Okay, since I'm done configuring, I'll use end to return to privileged exec mode. Now let's save the running configuration. There are three Cisco devices in this lab. I'll use a different method to save the configuration on each device to show you each one. Here on R1, I'll use copy running config startup config and hit enter to confirm. Now let's check if it was saved to the startup config. Show startup config. Here are the interfaces, and you can see the configuration changes we made. Okay, that's all for R1. Before moving on to switch one, I'll make the only configuration change we need to make on the PCs, configuring their IP addresses. Let's go on PC1. Click on config, and notice I pre-configured the gateway, which is R1's address, because it's the router for the network. Now, click on Fast Ethernet 0, which is PC1's network interface. PC1's IP address is 172.16.0.1. I hit Tab, and it automatically fills in the appropriate subnet mask, 255.255.0.0. Okay, now I can exit out. Next is PC2. Click Config, Fast Ethernet 0, IP address 172.16.0.2, hit Tab and it fills in the subnet mask. Next is PC3. Config, Fast Ethernet 0, IP address of 172.16.0.3, hit Tab to fill in the subnet mask, and exit. Finally, PC4. Config, Fast Ethernet 0, IP address of 172.16.0.4, hit Tab to fill in the subnet mask, and exit. Okay, now let's configure switch 1. Enable conft first the hostname. Hostname switch 1. Now let's check out the interfaces. Do show interfaces status. This is a command that works on switches, but not routers, by the way. As you can see, all default settings. No descriptions, the statuses are connected or not connect, not disabled, because these are switch interfaces. They are not shut down by default. The speed and duplex are auto and auto as well. Okay, let's configure the G01 interface. Interface G01, speed 1000, duplex full. It's connected to R1, so description to R1. That's it. Now G02. Interface G02. Speed 1000, duplex full. It's connected to switch 2, so description to switch 2. Now, as for Fast Ethernet 01 and 02, they are connected to end hosts, so according to the lab instructions, I don't need to configure the speed and duplex. So I'll just configure descriptions. Interface range, F01 to 2. Description, 2 end hosts. Now, as for the rest of the interfaces, I'll configure descriptions and shut them down. There are 22 unused Fast Ethernet interfaces. So, interface range, F03 to 24. Description, not in use. Shutdown. Okay, let's check the configurations. Do show interface status. Okay, you can see the interfaces we disabled. Again, because I configured the duplex manually on G02, it's down at the moment, but will come up when we configure switch 2. Notice the speed and duplex we manually configured. This is also a problem with Packet Tracer. It says A-1000 and A-full, meaning it auto-negotiated the speed of 1000 and duplex of full, which is incorrect because we manually configured it. On a real Cisco device, this will say simply 1000 and full, without the A. Anyway, I'll type end to return to privileged exec mode. Now let's save the configuration. This time, I'll use write memory. Okay, let's check the startup config. Show startup config. Okay, you can see the changes we made to the interfaces here. Let's go on to the last device, switch 2. Enable conft, hostname switch 2. Let's check the interfaces. Do show interfaces status. As you can see, all the defaults again. Now, the configurations we will make are the same as for switch 1, except switch 2 has only one active gigabit Ethernet interface, G01. So, I'll run through the configurations. Interface G01, speed 1000, duplex full, description 2 switch 1. Interface range F01 to 2, description 2 end hosts. Now let's shut down the other interfaces all at once. Interface range G02, F03 to 24. Description, not in use. Shutdown. Now let's check. Do show interfaces status. Once again, notice the speed of A-1000 and duplex of A-full. On a real Cisco device, this will be 1000 and full, without the A, because these settings were manually configured, not auto-negotiated. Finally, let's save the configurations. End. This time I'll just use write to save the configuration. Now let's check. Show startup config. Looks like our configuration changes were applied. That's all for this lab. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel, like the video, leave a comment, and share the video with anyone else studying for the CCNA. If you want to leave a tip, check the links in the description. I'm also a Brave verified publisher and accept BAT or Basic Attention Token tips via the Brave browser. That's all for now.